How common are parasites globally?
They're virtually everywhere. They make up about half or more than half of our world's biodiversity.
I want to build like a deep appreciation for parasites at the same time as acknowledging that it's like a little bit gross.
Yeah, but they can be so beautiful.
Welcome to Wavelengths, where we talk about our planet with experts from Scripps Institution of Oceanography, covering everything from the deep sea to the edge of the atmosphere. I'm Kate Furby, a marine biologist and journalist. I got my PhD here a few years ago, and now I'm back, learning more about what's happening at Scripps.
We're here today with Anaí Novoa. She studies parasite ecology. She's a PhD candidate here at Scripps. Thanks so much for joining us today.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
Can you tell us what a parasite is?
Well, we have various classifications of parasite. So a parasite, it has a symbiotic relationship with the host. So meaning it lives with it, on it, it uses the host as a resource. Sometimes it can be more hurtful than others. So sometimes, for instance, when we have a tapeworm inside us, one doesn't do too much damage. 100, we need to get pumped.
Can you tell me like about how it feels to be in a field? Like it's kind of gross, but it's also like extremely cool and important.
Parasites are really cool for one reason. Is that they're really good at what they do. The body of the host is very, it doesn't want to get infected. It's doing everything it can to destroy a parasite intruding its body. But when the parasite is successful, because some of them are just end up going in the wrong host and they die. But other times when they get in the right host and they establish their that, is quite spectacular.
Yeah, like parasites are living in a place that is literally actively trying to kill them. We know that climate change, like temperature changes around the planet, are also moving animals. Like animals want to live at a certain temperature. I prefer 75. Mm-hmm. And so they're moving to stay within that temperature. And the question is, which we have no idea, is like, will the parasites go with the host or will they struggle and to survive and stay behind?
Yeah, so climate change is affecting where animals live, breed, and move. As the planet warms, animals are moving to accommodate to stay within a certain temperature. For example, I study a small parasite called a trematode. It's a small flatworm. This animal moves through different host bodies for different phases of its life. So first, it lives in a marine snail, then in another second intermediate host, like a fish. And then finally, as an adult, it moves into a bird. But it needs that fish to get eaten by the bird in order to move bodies. So it can actually alter the behavior of that fish to help it get eaten.
Are we worried about then the parasites finding a different host and just totally changing the ecosystem that way?
Yeah, so we don't know what's happening with these species that are establishing in their new expanded range. We don't know what's happening in their southern edge. Are they still there? Or how does their abundance look like? And so in order to better understand those projections, what the future may look like, we need to know what it looks like now.
So which parts of the fish do you find the parasites in?
Everywhere. I find them in the scales, in the fins, in the gills, in the eyeball, in the musculature, and in the brain.
Oh my God. Gross and cool. Brain parasites. It's not ideal. So it's the ones in the brain, though, that change the behavior.
Mm-hmm.
This feels like a pretty vulnerable time to be a human. I'm thinking a lot more about how the world works as a whole. And it sounds like the work that you're doing is really important for us to understand how things are working and how they might change going into the future.
Definitely. Parasites are often overlooked in studies, and they are a really important piece to understanding what's going on in an ecosystem. And they can also help us better understand and provide insight into creating predictions for the coming future.